So in this way, as one engage into the Guru Yoga practice and go through the supplication prayer through which that one's mind stream be mingled with the Guru's mind stream, and then according to that the blessing as one as it one could receive through which that all sorts of karmic obscurations can be purified, and then one can receive the actual blessing of the body speech mind of the Guru, and that way one can get the actual benefit. So we are somehow from beginningless lifetimes that wandering in the samsara, that even we don't know what sorts of forms we have took and what forms we have not been taken, and what sorts of karmic activities what we have just done. In that way, we have been just wandering in the samsara. So somehow, fortunately, within this lifetime, one have obtained the precious human rebirth. That just depending upon previous lifetime, how much one have accumulated those merit. So what we have obtained, this precious support, we should not waste it, and we have to take the total advantage out of it. So the obtaining human form is not like a kind of random thing that just one being born as a human. It is just depending upon many past lifetimes, how much one have accumulated those merit, and according to that one obtain this precious human form. So there is nothing to be prideful just obtaining the human form, but what we need to realize or understand is that based on this human support, that where one could engage into Dharma practice to really attain the complete enlightenment, and that is our main responsibility. And then, of course, we know all the parallel sentient beings equal to the space, that wandering in the sixth realm, that going through all this kind of suffering days and nights. So that way, just to liberate all those beings from the samsara, and for that reason one should think and make that commitment based on this our human support as the true support for to attain enlightenment, and that way one have to think properly.
Pamatanji dungan narikimba nyongimba jire te de na tanji Deva to be chedu, wrong gari, you know. Tisa no tongira madu, wrong sipoji, apoji, gavoji, some of the gari chon madus.
So right now, we are experiencing a temporary happiness, but still all the apparently beings are, you know, constantly going through all sorts of, you know, suffering. So just thinking about how one can liberate them and lead them into, you know, happiness, that way one should do all the time concentrate, not just thinking for one's own benefit or one's own happiness.
Pamale, Kinchemo, Hamago, Mumbitoge, Tendet Mombo Yere, Tenata, Tenesano, Sinchuka Matos.
So, of course, in many ways, we didn't realize or know that how apparently beings are just, you know, very grateful and kind to oneself. It is because of the ignorance that one should not have such kind of, you know, wrong thought.
Yenda mumbo samarki na rangis zubo de sit tingi shundu tele sono tundo te hakure zubo de mena di tenti kanji seonge deva panjo ta kan zonge kare na te on togu marwas.
So even we don't have to just kind of, you know, think so many things, just even thinking of this, our, you know, kind of physical body, that from where we just, you know, obtain, and based on that, if we, you know, think of it comes from one's, you know, just parent, and even this within this worldly life, you know, where whatever we think, like, you know, all those happiness or entertainment, one cannot enjoy if we don't have this support of the human form. So of course there are beings, people who think that parents are not necessarily kind, or, you know, where don't have to feel grateful. That is, you know, just completely wrong, 100% wrong, and one should not be thinking in that way. And moreover, one should, you know, concentrate that how one can, you know, help and benefit them, including doing those, you know, aspiration prayers. So without having our just, you know, parent, of course we could not obtain this, you know, physical body, and then we cannot achieve, you know, temporary happiness and ultimate happiness, including the enlightenment. So in that way, even we just, you know, examine ourselves, of course there are so many ways we can understand. Even just for one day where we, you know, kind of want to be happy and peaceful, you know, how difficult and hard it is. And in that way, one should understand how rest of all the apparently sentient beings, that how one can help and benefit. And according to that, whatever this Dharma practice one do, and try to do the aspiration prayers, and then dedicate all those merit to all those human beings. And thinking that oneself is great and wise and rich and so forth, you know, having that kind of pride, that not necessarily one could have that, you know, ultimate happiness through that. So when that day, even one could have the whole complete wealth of the world to oneself, but still when that death happens, one cannot carry anything, including like a thread or needles. So when we leave from this world, what we can just carry with ourselves is that whatever that negativity we have just accumulated, and then maybe a little bit of those dharma practice what we have done, that is only that we can carry with ourselves. So in that way, that not thinking that I'm just great or just good, and besides that having such kind of jealous thought to others, and it is not good. Instead of that, all the time, if one could have developed the compassion, loving kindness to all those beings, and try to maintain one's mind stream in such kind of practice, it is just good. All these beings, whether it is big or small, without having any kind of anger, just emotion, instead of that, even one do aspiration prayers for them, it is always become positive. So in that way, just always try to watch your mind stream, and then try to work that whatever negativities, as much as one can abandon and get rid of it, and then to engage into anything that which is a virtue and the meritorious, that way one should work in everyday practice.
Okay, thank you.